Hey guys, welcome back, or welcome for the first time if you're new. So in today's video, I am going to be working on something I've been kind of inspired to do for a few weeks now, and I just never got around to it, and that is painting a self-portrait. Every now and again, I do this. It's not the first time that I've painted a self-portrait, but it has been a little while since the last time, and because my Patreon guide word for the month of October was self, it just seemed like it was very fitting. To start things off in this video, I chose a random page in one of my art journals. This page had a few layers down already that I could use as a little bit of a base, and I did choose a page that felt very me, if that makes sense. Sometimes I like to push myself and my boundaries when it comes to my art. However, things that I do really like are things like the color blue and lace, and both of those were kind of incorporated into the spread already, so it just seemed like an appropriate place to draw a self-portrait. After I had decided on which page I wanted to use for my background, I selected the acrylics that I was going to be using to paint the face. I had a little bit of an internal debate between using acrylics and using gouache again, like I used in a semi-recent portrait painting video. And I will link that video both in the description of this video and in the cards. However, I did end up going with acrylics for this particular portrait. There are a couple of reasons for this, but the main reason was simply that I had lost track of where my gouache paints were, and I didn't really feel like digging around for them, and my acrylics were perfectly handy, so it just worked out this way. It also kind of is interesting that it is a self-portrait, and I do tend to use acrylics more often than any other type of paint. So it did just kind of work itself into the theme as well. Now, I did print off a reference photo of myself to sketch from. This was just a photo that I took one day when I was doing headshots for more professional types of projects. Now, once I had my acrylics picked out, I mixed some different skin tones on a little scrap of cardstock. I wasn't really going for perfection here, but I did try to match my skin tone as best as I could. Mixing skin tones in this way is something I'm just a little out of practice with. It's been a while since I have worked from references like this, and so actually trying to match colors is just something that is going to have to come back to me. And once I had my basic skin tone mixed, I just started blocking in the basic shape of the face. I could have sketched first, but for my art journals especially, I do like sketching on top of cheap acrylics with colored pencil. I am specifying cheap acrylic for this, and I typically use CraftSmart Apple Barrel style paints. And the reason I specify these cheap craft acrylics is that they are matte. At least for the most part, they are matte. In my personal experience, the times that I have experimented with more expensive paints, whether that be Liquitex Basics kind of mid-range paint or a more expensive golden paint, they are typically glossy finish. And it is borderline impossible to draw with any type of pencil on top of this glossy acrylic. So even though I have tried out using the more expensive types of paints, for my art journals, I really do just like craft paint. Once I had my basic shape of the face blocked in, I took a Prismacolor colored pencil. The color I was using here was Black Cherry, and I just started sketching in the basic features of my face. Of course, using the photo as a reference. I have always had a little bit of a difficult time drawing my own face. I think it might be because I'm just so connected to the way that my face looks that I have a hard time looking at it objectively and in terms of its individual parts. However, this time I was quite happy with the way that this sketch turned out, so I'm glad I was recording it this time around. Now, after my base lines were down, I started adding in shadows and just general dimension with different mixes of my acrylic paint. I added brown for the shadows and white for the lighter areas of the face, and I just started blocking that in pretty roughly and loosely. Now, when I am painting portraits in this manner, I do tend to alternate between using acrylics and redefining the pencil lines that I already put down. So you will see me do that quite a bit throughout this video, where I will add some acrylic and then I'll add some more pencil, then I'll add some more acrylic and some more pencil, and I'll just go back and forth. Once I had the shadows kind of blocked in where I wanted them, it was time to move on to the hair. Now, as you can see in the photo, my hair is really dark brown. It is almost black in certain lightings, and I've actually dyed it black before, and there is hardly a difference. However, I have been wanting to dye it bright green. This is not something I have done. I have tried to do it, but my hair is so dark that I would have to lighten it first. So it is just kind of a dream at this point. And instead of actually going through the process of lightening my hair and then dyeing it, I decided to incorporate the look into this portrait. I was hoping it would have the effect of calming down my desire that I have had for months to dye my hair green, but instead I think it just made me want it more because I think that it looks quite cool. So that's where my self-portrait kind of deviated a little bit from real life, but I think that's one of the fun things about drawing and art in general, especially when it comes to self-portraits. Nobody says that it has to look exactly like you. And instead, I was very happy in this particular instance to kind of give myself something that I have been dreaming about for a while. Now, once I had kind of blocked in the color of the hair, both its base color as well as some different shadows and highlights, I did go back in with the colored pencil again. And although I was really liking the look of the colored pencil as my line art, I did use an ink pen for my glasses. This is a zebra sign pen, I believe. I will link it in the description of this video. And this is one of my favorite ink pens for mixed media work. It is a hard nib brush pen, so you can get some really interesting line variation with a lot more control than you can typically get from a regular brush pen. After I had added in the glasses in ink, I was pretty happy with how the face itself was looking. So I decided to paint around it with the light blue color that I had already used in the background of the spread. And my reasoning behind this was simply to blend the focal point into the page a little bit more. In my mind, it was standing out a little bit too much. And so when I painted right up against the edges of my line art, I really started to feel like it was part of the page instead of just something that was sitting on top of it. And to kind of finish off this face, I had just a few more little touches that I added in, like using a portfolio oil pastel mixed with water to add some pink and some color just to the cheeks, as well as using a dark green colored pencil. And that is the color, it's just dark green, to outline around the eyes a little bit, because I was wearing eyeliner in the photo and I just wanted my eyes to pop a little bit more in the self-portrait. If you've never done something like this before, if you've never drawn a self-portrait, I would encourage you to give it a try. It can be a really fun experiment to do in something like an art journal where there's not a lot of pressure for it to be perfect, even for people who don't really draw that often. It's just extremely soothing and nice to be able to spend a good chunk of time focusing on yourself and kind of trying to represent yourself in a piece of art. So I hope you guys liked this video and that you found it interesting. Thank you all so much for watching. You can subscribe if you want to see more videos like this or very different from this in the future. And until next time, happy creating!